Today we are talking about stemming and lemmatization, and these are the essential steps that you need to perform in pre-processing stage while building NLP application. You might have noticed when you search in Google with some word, it might search for some other words as well, which are matching with that particular word, which is here I'm talking about talking, and then it will match a word talk. So what we are doing here is essentially reducing the word to its base word. And not only like Google search is just one primary example that I gave you for your understanding, but even in text classification, let's say you are doing sentiment classification and you are using some words such as talking during the classification review, product review. Then if someone has used the base word, which is talk, you know, talking, talk, talked in past tense, they all mean the same thing. So you want to map all those words to its base word. There is a value in reducing a word to its base word. I'm giving some other examples here. Eating, to eat. Ate is a past tense, but if you can map that to eat, which is the present tense, the base word, then it can have a value in your NLP application. Similarly, adjustable to adjust. You'll notice that to get the base word of a given word, sometimes you can use simple rule, such as if the word has ing as a suffix, just remove ing. Talking, walking, running. If you remove ing, you get the base word. Eating. There are other suffixes as well, such as adjustable, amicable, remarkable. So if you remove able, then you get the base word. So the point I want to make here is by using simple rules without using any language knowledge, just by using simple rules that if the word has ing, remove ing or remove able, you can have a list of these suffixes. And you can use the rule that remove these suffixes from a given word to get a base word. Since we are using fixed rules or heuristic, this process is called stemming. It's like stemming. You're just stemming the given word and getting the base word. But on some other occasions, applying just the fixed rule is not going to work. Ate to eat. You can't apply this rule. You have to have that knowledge of that language. So whenever you want to use knowledge of the language or a linguistic knowledge, jargon alert, linguistic knowledge is nothing but a knowledge of a language. When you want to use that knowledge of a language and you get the base word, that base word, by the way, is also called lemma. So eat is a lemma for eight. And this process is called lemmatization. So stemming is, just to summarize, using fixed set of rules, dumb rules that remove this X number of prefixes or suffixes to get a base word. Whereas lemmatization is a little more sophisticated, where you need to know the rules of that particular language. You need to have linguistic knowledge. You might be guessing already that with stemming, you can get into issues sometimes. For example, if you have word ability, if you just apply the dumb rules, it will remove ity and you will get this base word able, which doesn't mean anything. Whereas if you apply lemmatization, you will get the same word ability. But as you learn more about NLP application, you will realize that there is a value of both. So stemming and lemmatization both are used. And we are going to write some code. By the way, for stemming, we will use ntlk because spacy doesn't have support for stemming. There is an article where spacy authors have mentioned why they don't support stemming, because lemmatization, as you can already see, is more sophisticated, more correct. So they just have lemmatization support. But NLTK has both stemming and lemmatization, both they support both. So I'm going to show you NLTK and I will demonstrate stemming. I want to take a moment and talk about firstlanguage.in, which makes building NLP applications easier for you. You can perform various NLP tasks, which are shown here, via this platform. If you're using a spacy type of library, you download it, you run your code locally. If you are training a heavy model, you need higher compute resources such as GPUs. Whereas here, everything is in cloud. You just make an HTTP call, things run on the cloud. You don't need a local machine with a lot of compute resources. There is a demo which you can see by clicking on this link, and I have bought this bulb recently, and you see there is a negative review on Amazon. And when I copy paste this here and I select text classification, and when I say submit, it immediately classifies that as negative. And if I have a positive review, I just copy paste it here, and if I submit it, it will classify this as a positive. See, it's pretty powerful. So it makes things much easier for you. You don't need to have like too much like detailed NLP knowledge. You can just call APIs and get things done quickly for yourself. The free tier is something you can try today. You can just sign in and you can get an API access. Once you sign in, if you go to dashboard, you'll get your own API key, and you can use that API key to make the calls. They have SDKs available both in Python and TypeScript. Go check it out. The link is in video description below. And thanks firstlanguage.in for sponsoring this video. So let's go to a notebook. So I imported NLTK and spacy. And by the way, if you don't have NLTK installed, you can in your command prompt. In your command prompt, you can just run pip install NLTK. Very basic, right? To install it, I have already imported both of these libraries, and now I'm going to import Porter Stammer from NLTK. So from NLTK dot stem import Porter. You can just hit tab to autocomplete and Stammer. This is a class, so I'm creating an object of this class in Python. When you do this, this is a class and you're creating an object of this class, storing it here. There is other stammer as well called Snowball Stammer, but I'm just going to show you one. And I have a couple of words here, and you can say for word in words print. So I'll print a word and then some separation, okay, and stammer dot stem that particular word, and it prints it does the stemming and it prints the base word. So you see it applied fixed set of rules. So from it removed ing, got it, then when it has eats, it will remove s and it. If you have a base word, it will not do anything, so it is it. But notice this, it did not do anything, because stammer doesn't have a knowledge of a language. It is just using fixed rules. Adjustable, it is saying adjust. Rafting, raft. Look at this, ability, able. Able doesn't mean anything, but still you will notice that many applications, even production applications, they use NLTK, and using stammer could be efficient because it is faster. It just applies a bunch of rules. It doesn't require any language knowledge, and it can have a value in your NLP application. So although it is dumb, it can have a value. Now let's do lemmatization in spacy. So this was a quick demo of stemming in NLTK. So as usual, so I'm going to now create NLP object and say spacy.load en core web SM is small, you can use medium. I'm going to use small version of English language processing pipeline. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you have to watch previous video. And then I will create some document. So let's use the same word here. And see, in space, it's pretty straightforward. You can just say for word or for token in a doc, print token, some separator, and you can say token.lemma underscore. Notice this, eight, it reduces to eat. Eating, eat, see, it worked fine. Adjustable, it did not say adjust, because the lemmatization, the rules which are set by default English model, says that the base word for adjustable is adjustable. Ability is ability. But look at this, when you have better, it reduced that word to well. So it has this mapping rules in the trained model that you just loaded. So based on the language, based on what kind of model you're loading, you might be loading a different English model which will have a different rule. So this is a quick demo of lemmatization in spacy. If you, by the way, let me show you one more thing, which is this thing called token.lemma. So see, there is lemma and there is lemma underscore. So lemma is just printing a hash. So it's a unique hash of your lemma, which is a base word, because this is a trained English model with a fixed vocabulary. It has few thousand words, and for each word, it will have a unique identifier, sort of. And that is this hash. And you'll see that for eat, the hash is same. This is just for your knowledge, by the way. I just wanted to quickly show you different sentence. So I'll just do copy paste and I will try. I don't know if you all watch Mandalorian. Mandalorian is my favorite series on Disney. So Mando doesn't talk that much, but Mando talked for 3 hours. Hooray! Mando is becoming talkative. Mando talked for 3 hours, although talking isn't his thing. He became talkative. And I will remove. So see, talked, it reduces to talk. Talking is also reduced to talk. But talkative is still talkative, because this is how, as I said, this is how this particular model behaves. Sometimes you might want to modify a behavior, right? You want to customize it. So how do you do that? So if you remember our pipe names, so we have, for this particular model, the pipeline that we have is this. There's a talk to vector, tagger, parser, attribute ruler, and then there is a lemmatizer. Now, attribute ruler assigns attribute to a particular token, and you can customize it. So let me explain what I mean here. So let's say you have this sentence. Now, bro, bra, brew, all these are the, you know, you mean brother basically when you say this. But by default, the language model doesn't understand. This is slang, right? So it doesn't understand. So it will say bro is bro, bra is bra, right? And if you look at the first token itself, so like the first token is this, correct? Bro. And if you look at the lemma of that, it is bro, because it doesn't understand the slang. But let's say you want to customize this model. You know that bro and bra means brother. You can customize it by doing this. So what you do is, you go here, you get this particular attribute ruler by doing this. So you'll say nlp.getpipe attribute ruler. So it will give you that particular component from the pipeline. And then you can customize it by adding that custom rule, okay? So see here, I am adding a custom rule where I am saying this. So what I want to say is, I want lemma to be brother for few words. So for bro and bra, I want their lemma to be brother. Okay. So here you are assigning attribute, and attribute is lemma. So basically you're saying the lemma for the words that I'm going to specify here, and the way you specify those words, I mean, that is this. I'm just going to copy paste. You're saying for brother, bro and bra, make their base word to be brother. So you notice previously bro was bro and bra was bra. But when I run this again, bro is brother and bra is also brother. And for the bro, see the lemma was bro, but now the lemma became brother. So I hope this gave you some understanding of stemming and lemmatization. I don't have an exercise for this particular video, but I might add exercises in the future as well. So always check the video description below, because sometimes if I don't find time for the exercise while recording this video, and if I find time later on, I add those exercises and I talk about those exercises in the video description below. So always when you are watching my videos on my channel, any video, make sure you check video description, because I might have included more information after I publish the video. If I find some correction, if I want to add some exercises, some additional information, articles, I always add them in the video description. So make sure you check it out. I hope you're liking this series. If you do, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. One of the ways you can share this series is by posting on LinkedIn. LinkedIn, there are some serious folks. So you can post about this series so that other people learning NLP can also benefit. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any question, post in a comment box below.